What? I once worked on a friend's dad's computer. He had the hard drive divided into 6 partitions, C through J, with a documents directory tree on each one. Each new file appeared to be saved to a partition at random. I knew enough not to ask. Rather than doing folders, he created partitions. Technically works. It's just frowned upon, that's all. Making a partition is way harder though than... Anyways. That's so funny. Yeah, there's a lot of interesting filing system out there, you know? Yeah, you can reach your destination in many ways. Is it supposed to be this slow, guys? I feel like it's really slow. You know what? Maybe I also have some weird stuff built into my systems that I just don't quite realize is dumb. There's a good chance that there is some of it. I've tried optimizing my systems over the years, but... It's getting bottlenecked somewhere? Yeah, but where? I don't understand. It seems to be producing. Is it the amount that can be inserted into the machine? That's the problem? I mean, right now it seems to be getting bottlenecked by the... What's this? What are we even producing out of this? Is that... Hydrogen, okay. Yeah, I think it's just a bit slow. Would it be a really dumb idea to do it like this and then put a couple inserters? I don't know if that's the bottleneck. We can give this a try, I guess. This seems pretty dumb. You used to reinstall Windows XP every 3 to 5 days? What the heck were you doing, man? I am a fan of reinstalling Windows occasionally, but 3 to 5 days? That seems a bit extreme, no? Fresh Windows install is still the best install, man. Although these days it doesn't really seem to be necessary. But it's still the first solution that goes through my mind whenever there's any computer problems whatsoever. Computer issue shows up? Well, I guess the fastest way to fix it is to throw off everything off of my computer. Just wipe everything. Your first OS you ever used was Microsoft DOS 5.0? Mate, I remember in elementary school we had computers that ran 3.1. I guess, wait, how does this work? Hold up. Was that Windows 3.1 or DOS 3.1? I actually don't know how it works. Yeah, DOS was before Windows, I know that much, but I guess that was Windows 3.1, right? Okay, okay. 3.1 was Windows? Okay, okay. And then after that came 8.1, right? Oh wait, no. They forgot how counting works. Bill Gates forgot that counting was usually done differently. Just insert them quick, okay? That's all I care about. Just get it done. That's what she said? Oh, God. That's horrible. Yeah, I need more hydrogen. Thank you very much, Milk the Muffin. Milk the Muffin, do you know the Muffin Man? The Muffin Man is kind of a legend. Pinball on the original Windows XP. I remember the pinball machine. I used a real old school, like, I think this was from like the early 90s pinball machine, not too long ago. Dennis has one. Take TV. Very fun. Like, genuinely very fun. Not very good. But you had to figure out how the game works by trial and error. Yeah, they're also pretty loud. They are pretty loud. Does Windows even still come with any games these days? Like, it used to have a bunch of different games, but... Not by default. You can get them from the store pretty easily. Okay. Grandma needs to use Game Pass. Don't be cheap, Grandma. Solitaire's on Game Pass now. I know, game. I'm trying to solve it. Jeez, man. The game keeps shouting at me that I'm bad at the game. Yeah, I actually remember that. When I upgraded this computer to Windows 11, it did come with a whole bunch of freaking Microsoft bloatware installed. It was stupid. I guess those are ads as well, right? They must be getting a lot of money for, like, making it automatically install Candy Crush and shit on my computer. Luckily, it was very quick to uninstall, but... Blizzard games will probably never be on Game Pass? I think it will. Very good chance they will be on Game Pass. Am I making the wrong thing? Oh shit, I am making the wrong thing. Fuck. I meant to make these. Okay. It's actually pretty hype, man. The idea of being able to, like, say your World of Warcraft subscription is directly tied into Game Pass or something like that. It could actually be really cool. But I could also imagine that is gonna require a lot of work. And I don't know if they want to go through all the hassle. Does it not come pre-installed on Windows 11 Enterprise? Lowko, I'm here at DreamHack Atlanta crying because you aren't here. Sorry, dude. I wish I was. Oh, I see, sis.
I think I have Pro. I'm not sure.
So my real bottleneck is just hydrogen now, right? Since I've increased the height of the towers. Yeah, that seems to be the only thing that's really holding me back here. So we just need a bunch more. I wasted a little bit of my resource here. Okay, we'll make a bunch of them at once, but... yeah, it seems like red science in general is just a lot more stuff. Okay. I don't remember how long it took me to get all these sciences going in my previous playthroughs. I'm feeling relatively slow here so far, but that's okay. More hydrogen, please. Are you working? You are working. Excellent. Yeah, it's very red over here on the floor. Is that as much as I can fit here? I might be able to fit one more. Chat? Chat, no. Thank you. No, this is... I can't fit another. Come on! Buddy, no! Ay, ay, ay. Can't believe this. Yeah, well, sometimes I hear myself saying things. And, it's not on you. Oh, shit. I have a lot of beautiful oil over here. I guess I should have maybe built it up a little bit this way. How long is it gonna take until this is empty? I know, game. Just don't say anything that can be taken out of context. That's a great suggestion. What's going on, BBB Lion? Hello. There is definitely a research for me to make graphite. Oh shit, hold up. There is some fancy material here. Energetic graphite. I can make this as well. By putting oil? How do I do this? Okay, I can turn it into more stuff using up some of the oil that I'm not currently using. I don't know if that's worth it though. I have no idea, Black Saucony. I've been thinking about that Christmas gift for a while. Lauren got me a Christmas gift. She's given me the barest of hints and I cannot figure out for the life of me what she got me. What I know is that she went to a city, like, a month and a half ago. Not the city we live in, but she, like, specifically traveled for it. To go and pick up the gift early because it would not be available anymore later on. I have no clue. I have honestly no idea. Please be another cat. There's no way it would be another cat. There's no way. Vertical construction mark two. I haven't seen the hedgehog in a couple, like we've been looking for him. He's not been eating my food over the last couple of days. It's been probably like, I've been putting it out every night, and then I bring it back in. Like, after like 4 hours or so. I haven't seen it anymore. So I think he may have gone into hibernation, yeah. I think he may be hibernated, yeah. Could be. He moved out? He moved on to greener pastures, man. You disabled hibernation on your computer? Yeah, same. I had to change my registry settings yesterday, sysadmin. It was a very scary moment. But I did it, because I'm a big boy. It was also a very important thing. You wanna hear why I had to use dangerous registry updates? So I have this screen over here, right? My Windows Explorer thing, right? Over here, in the left bar, whatever this is called, the navigation menu, there was a freaking Creative Cloud folder from Adobe. Super freaking annoying. Stupid as shit. Like, it's just there. I never use it. And I couldn't remove it. And it turns out the only way you can remove this folder from the left side of your screen is by going into your registry. Fucking Adobe, man. Yeah, Adobe actually, like, considering I pay for this stupid software every month. Ay, ay, ay. They actively try to make their software worse. I would also like to get rid of gallery and home from the left side of the screen. If somebody knows if that's possible with, like, a registry edit, I would be very interested too. I guess you can. Why is there a home and a gallery button? Like, why is this a thing? I don't want to see that shit. Why would I want gallery, okay? Gallery in particular, this is not images, this is not pictures on your computer. This is a gallery for, I don't know. Ay, 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 ay. Thank you very much, by the way. Mr. Bunny Warren, starting up a giveaway for a mug. If you're watching this on Twitch, exclamation point enter in the chat. If you want a giveaway, anyway, I don't know. Thank you, dude. Very nice. Oh, no! You have all this junk? This stupid folder is what I'm talking about. Fuck this folder, man. This is, like, I was actually spending time on trying to get rid of this stupid folder. Why is this here? Nobody uses that folder. I don't know who would. I use other like cloud services. Like I don't want the Creative Cloud stuff. It's so annoying. Creative Smite? No way, dude. Genuinely though, some of these Adobe things are dangerously close to just being straight up malicious. Like, it's just so annoying. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So here's somebody asking about it. How to remove Creative Cloud files shortcut? How to remove this? People come up with all kinds of solutions. Editing the registry to get rid of that. It's frustrating, though. Adobe really does try to actively make their software worse. It's impressive. Like, there, it's very clear that there are some very talented people working at Adobe, and they make some really brilliant stuff. And then there's a bunch of guys over there that, like, are not very smart. Like, I don't know what the hell they're doing, but they're, like, genuinely just making stuff worse. Hey, I can fit one more. It's the little things that bother me, though. Like, none of it is particularly significant, I guess. But it's just annoying. Yeah, they're very anti-consumer. Yeah. It's rough. Are the inserters unpowered? Ooh, nice catch. But especially, like, it's not even cheap software, you know what I mean? It's not like they're charging, like, $12 for... Like, no, it's pricey. I need more oil. I guess we're gonna bring some more oil onto this conveyor belt. Hey, congratulations, Big Dodo. You won a mug! Congratulations. Thank you, buddy. Generous as always. Oh no. Now I'm just straight up using the wrong thing. Okay. Well, that did not help. I guess this still was a good addition, though. Good on Growling Blair. Hello. They've raised prices? Have they really? Adobe Photoshop is now 23 euro a month. Or $23 a month. They add so much junk to this sort of plan, though. Like, that's the stupid part about it, you know? Like, they add so much bloat. Like, I don't want Adobe Express Premium plan with thousands of free templates. I don't want the mobile app. I don't care about Acrobat Pro or Illustrator or I don't care, man. 20,000 fonts, don't care. Tutorials included, don't care. They're actually losing quite a bit of market, I would imagine, though, because they really were better back in the day. There's a lot of good alternatives these days. Yo, Cypher also doing a giveaway. Thank you, man. A lot of merchandising today. Thank you. I actually lowered my my subscription for Adobe some time ago, and they do this other really shitty thing, where when you try to cancel your monthly subscription plan, they have you pay like an extra thingamajig because you apparently have to sign up for a year minimum or whatever, but they give you like a 30% discount or it was so stupid. Just, I don't know. Not a fan. If you're currently not sucked into the Adobe ecosystem, I don't recommend getting there. It is, there's a lot of good alternatives out there. I use Adobe Resolve these days. DaVinci Resolve, sorry, these days, yeah. The only thing I still use from Adobe is Photoshop. And Photoshop is genuinely very good. But it's the business practices around it that bother me, you know? There are alternatives for Photoshop as well, yeah. I would have to relearn all of it. There's a bunch of stuff, yeah. But that's what I mean, you know? Like, there are some, there are some weird decisions that some of those companies make where you're like, eh, why? Have I built the Lego bonsai? I did, dude. I did. There it is, dude. The Lego bonsai. It's actually really cool. There's a little frog. I don't know if you can see the little frog right over here. Right over there. Kind of difficult to see. Yeah. It was actually very fun. What's going on, Thing Man? Nitro Flare! Congratulations. Do I have enough now? Still not quite enough hydrogen here, huh? I gotta start burning some of this. Yeah, we need to wait until some of this is empty. Did I start up my research for... Oh, I did! When did I do that? Thermal power, yes. I can now burn it for electricity. Nice, clean oil. I don't know where it is, though. I'm gonna be heading off, yeah. But I wanted to check out my nice clean oil. Time does fly when you play these types of games. It's kind of nuts. Oh, it's right over here, obviously. Right at the start. Okay, let's make a couple. I don't know where I'm gonna burn it. I want to be able to expand my current thingamajig over here. So I guess I'll put him over here.
A thermal power plant?
Yeah, man.
This kind of power facility consumes chemical fuel. Ensure adequate fuel supply at all times so the plant can consistently generate power.
He seemed very impressed by my chemical power plant. The voice actor for this thing. Do you think it's a real person? I'm not sure. I kind of feel like it could be AI. A thermal power plant. All right, let's see. How much electricity does this generate? Burn! Burn it all! Can I see the amount of electricity here somewhere?
Power.
Yes. Oh, okay. Look at that. I don't know how much of this is going to be consumed, though. Unlimited power? No, this is by no means unlimited. It's actually very limited, Galvarino. This is like one of the most limited forms of power. We're literally burning a non-renewable, but it's okay. I should burn it all. I mean, I don't have any other use for it right now. And just like on planet Earth, we could just go to another planet when we run out, you know? That's the plan we have in IRL, no? Okay, so that should give me at least a nice little boost. Yeah. Yeah, we went from about 30 megawatts to about 40 megawatts. Very good. All right. Gonna be saving it here. Gamers, welcome back to this abomination of a base that I have been building. It really is kind of ugly, especially after just playing Factorio, where I had, at least what in my mind, was a very well laid out and organized base. I know some of you may disagree, which is fair enough, but this really is a bit of an ugly one. I've been trying to do a decent job making my base look decent. But there's plenty of spaghettiing going on. I think a lot of it will be solved as soon as we have robots that can like fly around and help me organize things. Also, I now have robots that are moving stuff away out of my backpack. I just realized that. This is a new tool that they have in the game, where these fidget spinner looking robots basically deliver resources and items to me. Yeah, I don't have to manually do it anymore. So we can pave the world pretty easily. I've got a little bit of electricity coming up over here, just a tad. A little bit of it. My main concern is the upcoming attack wave. So there is a threat level over in the top right, or top left hand corner rather. And I'm gonna need to make sure I have some turrets and whatnot set up for that. The problem is that it's difficult to determine where the enemies are gonna be attacking from. And, I can't really put turrets everywhere. So I think this is just a line that basically leads to the other side of the planet. And they can just come in from anywhere. So I find it kind of difficult to decide when and where I should be expecting it, but... at the very least, now we have logistics robots over here delivering me random things, which is kind of neat. I think we should just continue teching up, right?
Hey, Toby.
Do you want to chill here, Tope? You want to say hi to the chat?
Hey, buddy. Is he even on camera? There we go.
Sometimes the cat is kind of chill and he can just not destroy my Christmas tree. And other times he's like, fuck the tree. Do it fast. Do it aggressively. Fuck it up. We'll have to see what Toby we're getting today. Always a bit of a question. Anyhow, I did set up one turret. The problem is that there are so many different arms, I guess, to my base. Like, look at the range of this turret. It's decent, but I can imagine there's a very good chance that the enemies are not going to be fighting on over here. So I'm kind of struggling with that a little bit. At the same time, I did set up this thing too, which is a battlefield analysis base. I don't fully understand how it works. When enabled, base will automatically pick up nearby trash. But the range on this tower is pretty short. I think that's maybe like an upgrade that I can maybe like improve it on. Because that would make a lot of sense. Combat drone damage, combat drone attack speed. Ground squadron expansion. Space fleet expansion. Alright, well we'll get water, we'll just get basic damage for now, I guess. That's, can never really go wrong with that. I did get some dudes that I couldn't, I think, put in my fleet. Prototypes. Precision drones. And attacking drones. So I did make a bunch of them, but I think I put them all in this tower. I think I maybe can carry a bunch of them around myself as well. I should have a look. Yeah, this the glass situation is a bit annoying. I definitely need a lot more stone. Did I set up a storage for stone? I don't think I did. No, I did not set up a storage for stone. I don't think we want to be making a million of these, by the way. You hate silicon production? Yeah, it is a bit tedious. It's okay though, once you get going a little bit later on. Like usually, at least from what I remember, once you get to other planets, there are literally planets out there that just have silicon. So you just mine it, you know? You just mine it and smelt it into bars and that's it. So I think ultimately that's what we want to try and do, but right now I'm not really in a position yet to be able to transport resources from one side of a system to another. That'll come up at a later time. But I'm just using some new tools right here, right? Like, for example, the... this stuff, the logistics distributor. So I can set up a request for that stuff, although currently I apparently don't even have any... Yeah, currently I don't actually have a an extra slot available for that, but... Yeah, you can get silicon from stone. That's what you do early on, but that's not really what you do later on, though. It's not very efficient. Can I have a look at more inventory space somewhere? Not yet. Mecha movement speed? That one's manageable. Albeit a bit of an expensive one, but... Buy out technology? What? Instantiate? Really? Instantly buy, I guess is what they mean. And use metadata to directly unlock technology? That's New Game Plus? Use Proliferator? I just need some of these basic improvements, man. When you GG out, you get research points you can use in New Game Plus. Oh, shit. Okay. So you can kind of skip a lot of the early game stuff. You can just go straight to, like, logistics drones if you really wanted to. Interesting. That's actually kind of cool. Is that new? Or has that been around for a little bit? I don't know what I should be focusing on at the moment, guys. I have, I'm wandering around a little aimlessly. I guess ultimately what I want to get is just logistics drones flying around for everything. What's going on, MCU? Thank you for the 64. I'm not planning on going back to God of War Ragnarok at the moment, no. Hydrogen fuel rods. Pretty nice. But I don't think that's what we're looking for. Precision drones. Titanium smelting, I'm definitely going to need. Tier 2 conveyor belts. I think what I need is planetary logistics, right? This will make life 10 times easier. It requires quite a few resources, though. Yeah. So I guess we'll queue up titanium smelting. I will try and get this going. So titanium, I can only get it. I don't know if I have any titanium on my current system or in my current planet. I think I may need to very well just import it. Yeah, I think I need another planet for that, don't I? So this one has... Can we scout that already? I think there's a research for that too. No, I don't think we can actually see yet what's inside of some of these things. There are some enemy ships, by the way, moving out of the system. There's small amounts and giant rocks on my planet. Yeah, but that's not really what I'm looking for. What do I need in order to go into... What do I need in order to fly to another planet? Can I already do that? I think I can't quite take off and leave another... Yeah, exactly, that's what it's called. Dive engine. Extra movement speed is always nice. View ores on the planetary system, right. So that's a bit of a no-brainer. Dive, what was it? Dive engine. Is that in my upgrades? I think it is, right? Dude, there are so many these days. Holy crap. It's almost a little bit overwhelming, but I guess ultimately you just kind of go to what you need to go eventually, right? Now, for this, I also need titanium, don't I? I think so. So, the yellow matrix is not really going to be something I will get anytime soon. That's for blueprints and whatnot. Drone engine. Oh, it's here. Unlocks mecha cruise. Yeah, that's it. Okay, we'll queue that up too. Did anyone hear that knocking? I don't think there was knocking in my room, Andy. Lauren generally doesn't knock, she just walks in. I'm already out of fuel for this. Very nice. I wanted to store some of my fuel. I don't know if this is a great thing to do, by the way, because I'm burning off the excess fuel that I have. I guess it's okay. It's just slightly inefficient, because I could be using this stuff as well to create more hydrogen, but... Looks like it's actually going quite smoothly now, though. We're actually producing quite a bit of this. Yeah, the sign's actually not going bad. I'll just keep that the way it is. So I'm automating processors. Processors are... At least something I know I'm gonna need quite a bit of. Another thing I'm gonna need quite a bit of is these electric motors, right? Or I guess electromagnetic turbines? I guess both. Do I want to automate the production of that? Ultimately not a bad idea. Like, which one should I automate, guys? Does anybody have any suggestions? Because I'm... like, automating all the things does not really seem... too efficient right now, because at some point we will have logistics, I guess, for that sort of stuff. But if anybody has a suggestion, let me know. I could just automate it and hope for the best, but... There are four belts? What do you mean? You automate everything? So ultimately, I do want to automate everything. It's just that this first starter planet is so messy, because I don't really have the technology to ship stuff around very effectively. So, what I want to aim for eventually here, at least in theory. Belters and sorters? I should probably automate those. Yeah. Yeah, I guess we'll just start with that. So we have conveyor belts. That is literally just the most basic of basic stuff. Dark Swarm is launching an assault. Oh, here we go. I kind of want to see how strong these tower things are. I'll start one up, I guess. Can I interest you in some bullets?
Is short of ammo. Most turrets need ammo to fire. Click on a turret to open its panel.
A turret?
Replenish ammo manually.
How did First,
it'd be better to constantly supply ammo with conveyor
There we
belts.
Go. Oh, here's one of my turrets already firing. So, they literally just killed it. Jeez, dude. These guys are actually becoming pretty scary. I don't even know what happens when I die. You can ship stuff with fidget spinners? Yeah, but how do I... Wait, was this thing already empty? I put 100 bullets in it. I thought the fidget spinners were only transporting to me. Oh, that's what I can do. So wait, can I set a request? How do I require a request? A request chest. That's possible? Like, how do I set up a demand for that sort of stuff? It's the same? I have logistics over here in my inventory. Say I have a regular chest set up over here. Set filter, set uniform filter, set existing name, clear all filters. Oh, if I build the little thing on top of it, I can... Oh, I can request stuff over here. Interesting. Okay, so that actually changes stuff then. I did not realize that part. So, I can... Oh, that actually changes everything. That would allow me to basically just build wherever I like, because I already have a... basic demand for a lot of these things. So let's give that a try then. I have some space over here. We'll use some more paving, I guess, because I may as well. I want to just set up some basic stuff. Because I'm kind of running out of the basic resources, like conveyor belts and that sort of stuff. So I can put up a chest, like the one that I just made, and request basic items? Thank you very much, W. 3 years! Appreciate that. So I can put 10 dudes in here and set up a demand for, say, iron ingots. That would work? Ay, ay, ay. Hey, thank you for the 3-year support, W. Long time. So, my dudes are currently in here. Are they gonna pick up those items? Is that them delivering those items to my chest? No. Do I have to toggle this on? Yeah, I think I may have to toggle that one on. I thought this was it supplying two other chests. I do have a provider chest right over here with tons of it, and that one also has it toggled on, but it says zero available routes. That one is very close by. But that doesn't work. I thought I tried that out yesterday. Oh, Oh, you can flip the switch to make it a request chest instead. Oh, shit. Okay, well, that is not 100% clear, is it? Even when you just said it, I didn't notice it. Okay. That's big. Okay, so I can just do the most basic stuff. We can just do conveyor belts. Conveyor belts are plates and those gears. I'll have to make the gears first. I don't need that many of them. We'll just do like two of them. I need like an output, I guess. This is my output line. We'll do a little bit of a loop. Because I like loops. Then I want to set up an output line over here as well. Suddenly we're Factorio. That does mean I need a lot more of those things though than what I currently have. Loop, not lube. Ay, chat. This is a game changer though. All jokes aside, actually huge. We can already start like a little mini automated bus thing over here. So I want to set this one up to be conveyor belt production. Conveyor belts go in like so. And I want this running into a chest over here on the right. I didn't realize you could flip the switch on those things, man. That's massive.